What's the purpose of this tree view? Well, the purpose of the tree view is only in as far as you use it to send connections or to establish connections to send data to other web parts. So in my example, what I'd like to do is send the context over to here. Now that this trend. Now what I have to do in order to do that is first establish a connection by going into this, well, first going into build mode and then going into the connections option. I'll establish a connection and then I'll modify my trend so that my trend is going to be an element relative display. So let me go ahead and into edit mode here. I'll establish a connection, and the connection here is going to be to send parameters to the PI trend. Now that doesn't really accomplish anything yet. All it does is inform this trend that is a supplier of connections. I need to go in and modify this trend and decide what I'm going to use from that tree view. Now if you recall, on these builder screens you see these little lightning bolts to indicate that that's where a connection can be made. When the connection is black, or that icon is black, then there is no connection at this point. What I'd like to do is establish establish that this is what we're going to be looking at here is not going to be a hard-coded tag name, but what we're going to be looking at, our data, is going to be a reference to an element attribute in AF. So I'm going to go out and look at that, it was called the data flow within that flow meter. So I'll go out and find that. This is our first step in making this element relative. I'll go ahead and find that flow meter. This was Houston that I was looking at. And from here, we drill down to the flow meters. Now I'm going to choose a specific element, this flow rate. We've added that there. That now becomes an element all by itself in this list here, and the context for that is listed over here. This attribute context path is specific to that. It's telling us that that is the flow rate for this context. And let me go ahead and get rid of this CDT158. And notice when I choose the PI tag, that context goes away. Let me just get rid of that. So now this is going to be element relative. Now I still haven't accomplished my goal here, because if I get out, even if I go into run mode, there is no relationship yet. There is no relationship between what I select here and the fact that this is an element relative display. It's element relative only in that I have an attribute in the builder screen that supplies the path. So it's showing that's the element and here's the path. So the big finish to this is let's complete the work of that connection and go ahead and establish that we're going to get that element path from that PI TreeView web part. So I'll choose connections. We can see this is actually the handiwork of our connection earlier on. If you remember earlier, I established a connection between these two. So we now see that that connection exists. And here are the list of things that I can consume from that PI TreeView web part. The one I'm interested in is the element path. Now that you see that this is green, that indicates that there is a connection. And the big finish here is that when I switch from one node to the next, that switching of nodes is going to pass a new path, which will generate a new result, you know, in the lookup between that flow rate element name and this element path that we see here. Now that's just one way we could do this. There's other ways we can do it. One interesting option would be, instead of taking an element path, we can receive other things from this this tree view. I can retrieve, in fact, the full list of PI tags that are organized under that node. That's a very interesting option. And so instead of having, let me demonstrate. Instead of having a retrieval, as we just did here, in which we're just retrieving a path, let me go out and instead establish a connection that brings over this PI tag list. Now, PI tag list means that everything in, or all the tags organized under that node will be brought over. So I don't need this anymore. You know, this is just a slightly different way of doing the same thing. But there are times when this is superior, especially when you've got, and especially when you have these element names that are different. Now here, we really haven't demonstrated anything different, but watch the usefulness of this. If I go in and modify this, my tree view, so that we show more than just this, that'll show you the power of bringing over a tag list. So I'll go back in, modify this, and let's take a look at some of those things that I ignored earlier. I ignored earlier the number of levels to display. And let me go ahead and change the number of levels. Actually, before I do that, let me set the root higher. Right now the root is way down at the flow meter level. I'm going to put it right at the Houston level. So I'm going to specify this is my root, this is my root. Actually, let's go with equipment list. What do we have under there? We'll go with Houston. We'll use this as our root. And then for the default, I'll just use the default. I'll specify the same one that we saw before. Didn't really have to change that. That root is not going to help me much if I'm only looking at two levels. So let me increase this. We don't need 8. Let me increase this to 5 levels that are both initially loaded and displayed. Yeah, so now, if you look, we've got, we're starting at Houston, we're going down 5 layers, and as we did before, as we switch from one to the other, we're seeing the individual tags. But if we switch to these others, now we're seeing the tags that are organized under those nodes. Now the natural, I can look under just about everything within Houston. Yeah. Now when you run into a node that has no tags, you'll get what we just saw. Yeah, we don't see anything there. It must be something underneath the 6th or underneath the 5th level there that we're not looking at. And if I go up to the top here, we won't see anything. We're only going to be passing over those values, those tag lists for the node that are currently selected. And we've only looked at a couple of the features of the PI TreeView. Other things you can do with this is you can configure, for example, special extended attributes that will allow you to pass the name of a file from this tree view over to, for example, an RT graphic, so it would show a different graphic file. You can also specify one by one exactly which attributes you want to pass to different web parts. So there's a lot more you'll find in the PI Web Parts User Guide.